Some teams might be following like an agile methodology and have scrum meetings. And
Alexandra, thank you for being a guest on The Art of the Meeting. I'm so excited to hear about your engineering team meetings.
Hi, Manuela. Thanks for having me on. I'm really excited to talk to you about this too.
Yeah, so why don't you go ahead and give us your definition of what an engineering team meeting is?
Yeah, so an engineering team meeting is pretty much what it sounds like. It's a lot of engineers getting together to talk through things. A lot of different companies and different team styles can have a lot of different ways of running this meeting. So some teams might be following like an agile methodology and have scrum meetings and retros and all sorts of different things. But for us, we really use engineering team meetings as a way to get everyone together, talking, making sure that we're all up to date on things that are going on and having good discussions.
Yeah. So what would you say the purpose of the meeting is?
Biggest purpose for the engineering team meeting for us is aligning on priorities and seeing work in progress demos of different things going on, talking through technical challenges, but really just making sure that everybody is aligned on what's going on in the broader engineering organization and what the other teams are up to, so that we know what's happening and know about anything that we need to be aware of that might affect our work.
Okay, and at Fellow, who attends this meeting?
A lot of different people attend the meeting. It's grown a lot in size over the last few years. So we have every single engineer at Fellow, all of the engineering managers, everyone in QA, so quality analysis, the product managers, the data engineers, DevOps. So it's gotten to be a large meeting, which if anything gives it more importance because we have a lot of different teams working together. And this is the one time that we get to come together and tell everyone what we're up to. We did start it off as a bi-weekly meeting, which we started, I think about 3 years ago or so. We started running it bi-weekly and we actually changed it to weekly a couple weeks into the pandemic when we started working from home last year, because we found that it was a really good time for everyone to get together and see people face to face, so to speak, and get a little bit more social interaction. Because outside of this meeting, like every engineering team gets to see their team members 3 to 4 times a week, but we weren't really seeing the people on other teams all that much. And when you're running that at a bi-weekly cadence, 2 weeks is a long time to go without seeing people working in the same area as you. And so we found having it weekly gives us a chance to catch up with one another. We do a lot of just small talk at the start of the meeting, and it's a good way to get to see each other.
Okay, awesome. So show us your agenda and what through each section of the template and why you've decided to include that section.
So this is the template that we use right now for the dev team weekly agenda. We start off with small chat, which isn't a part of the official agenda. It's just very light, asking people how their weekend was, asking what's going on in their lives and updates and whatnot. And then we jump into small wins, which is something that we added because we've been doing this in our weekly town halls with the whole company, where we give each other shout outs and talk about the things that are really great that are going on, just as a kind of a mood lifter. So we added this section to the dev team weekly agenda as well to talk about things specific to engineering that are going on that were really good. So we start off with this, which lasts about 5 minutes usually. And then we jump into demos. And the demos can be anything from work in progress features that people are building, which is really interesting to see, like when it's not quite ready to go live on production yet, but we get like a sneak peek at what's going on, what people are working on. But we also have a lot of people on the team who are very excited about learning new frameworks and learning new like different development topics, and then teaching that back to everyone on the team. So every week we have about 2 to 3 different presentations where someone will talk about what they're building right now, and then another few people will talk about different like code refactoring they've done and the things that they learned as a part of that process, and then frameworks that like may or may not have anything to do with Fellow, but it's kind of cool that we all get to learn from that, which I love about the culture here, just like always learning, always growing, and always being willing to teach people about that stuff too.
Yeah, and I'm curious about this demo section. Like, do people just write down their names when they want to show something, or how do you handle that?
Yeah, so usually people will actually just come in here and write exactly what their demo is going to be about. So maybe we added new integration, we'll write the name of that there. And because it's a talking point, the person's face will show up there, so we know who it is that's going to be doing the demo. And then next we have discussion topics. And this processes usually encapsulates a lot of different things. Like usually there are updates from me or the other engineering managers about what's going on in the business, or we have some questions for people, or we specifically want to ask about feedback for how like a new process went, or let people know we're about to do a retro, anything like that. And then maybe other people on the team to have ideas about things we could be doing differently, or just different things to talk about as a whole. Because this is really the one spot where we get FaceTime with all the other engineers on the team. We can't just walk up and say, hey, I think we should work on this. And so it's good to note it down here so that we remember to all talk about it together.
How do you encourage people on the team to add talking points to the agenda?
Yeah, it was a struggle at first, I think. It's hard to remember to come up with ideas for it, but we've gotten really great at it over the last year. And one of the things that we started doing specifically to remind people that this is something that should always be top of mind is we created a Slack workflow. This is a new feature that Slack added back in October. We released the Slack workflows from October 2019, but in October 2020, they specifically released the ability for apps to create custom steps in workflows. And Fellow built a bunch of steps for this. And one of those steps is that you can, at a specific date and time, so in this case, like a half hour before or an hour or two before the meeting, you can take the notes from the agenda and automatically send them to a specific Slack channel.
So one question that I had for you is, has this agenda evolved over time?
Yeah, it has evolved quite a bit, especially because we keep asking people for feedback about how to change this. And there are always new ideas, especially as new members join the team. So we have made a lot of changes to it over the last little while. And so one of the things that we focused on the most before is the lightning talk aspect of it and asking for anyone if there were any updates. And we had a section specifically for asking about feedback as well. We found that people weren't always necessarily willing to put feedback directly in the meeting note, and it was much more effective to send out feedback requests specifically for that after meetings. Yes, we've added this small win section, which has been really great and very popular. Demos kind of encapsulate the lightning talks and work in progress so that we're not separating it out, which makes it feel like there should be a lot of importance on lightning talks and work in progress every time when that doesn't have to be the case. And one of the changes that we made relatively recently, which has also been really great, is we added specific moderator and note taker roles for this meeting. So not directly a part of the agenda, but it is an action item for us every week to decide ahead of time who is going to be in charge of moving the meeting along forward. And like telling people it's their turn to demo and making sure we're on track. So we have a role specifically for that, and then a role for someone to take notes about what's going on, write down any action items, talk about any decisions that were made and things like that. And we found that rotating those roles every week has been really great at making people better at running meetings, which is a skill that we value a lot at Fellow, and it's going to help people throughout their whole careers. And then it also makes sure that people don't end up falling into the same role every time, because there are some people who have a tendency to write a lot of notes and might take that role over when nobody else is doing it, which is, it's helpful, but it's not the best for everyone, because you want to make sure that everybody can fully participate in meetings and not have to worry about taking notes. So by rotating that role every week, we found that to be an effective way of making sure that everybody gets a chance to do a bit of everything.
That's really awesome. I love that concept of rotating moderator and note taker role. That's really cool. Well, thanks for showing us your agenda. This is really great. One last question I had for you is, how do you want people to leave this meeting feeling? Like, how do you want people to feel after this meeting?
Yeah, I think the best feeling to walk away with the meeting with is feeling empowered to go do some great work. I find that I always feel really uplifted walking away from that meeting, because there are so many engineers on the team who are so much smarter than I am, and they have the best presentations and they teach me so many things, and it inspires me. I aspire to be able to do what they do and go have that drive to learn and teach people things. And I think that seeing that and seeing the demos of what people are building for Fellow is really motivating. And so I think the signs of a successful engineering team meeting are when people feel like that.
That's amazing. That's a great way to end it. Thank you so much for sharing your template with us, Alexandra.
Thanks, Manuela.